Hi, I'm Philip from the HANA Academy. In this series of videos, we're looking at the XS Advanced model.
In this video, we're going to look at how you can build a Fiori Master Detail module, so UI5 module, as part of your XS Advanced application using Web IDE, using the template available with HANA 2.0 SPS 01. Now, there's been quite a few improvements made to this template compared to how it worked previously. We've created a database with a couple of tables, and we created an OData service in the previous video, so refer to the previous videos if you've not already seen those. What we're going to do now is create a new module. So for our project sales, create a new module, and this time we're going to choose the Fiori Master Detail module. If you don't see it in the list because you have your most recent items in the list, just hit more and then you'll get a full list. So it's the Fiori Master Detail module. Now, you give it a name. I'm going to call it UI, whatever you want. Hit next. This is where there's a very major change. Now, previously, you had to typically access the an XML file that you'd saved, which had the definition of the OData service. It couldn't connect to live OData services. That's now changed with SPS 01. In fact, you'll see that for the services, any services available in this project for OData, they are actually provided in a list of current project. So you can see that you've got services here. One of them is a Node.js, and it's a sales Node.js module, and it's actually up and running, and that's the one we created in the previous video. Now, if you're using Java, because you can also create OData version 4 services with Java, you could do that here as well. But I'm using Node.js, so it's up and running, which means we're going to be able to connect directly to that service. We're not going to have to do any manual configuration based on the, as I said, the metadata.xml that we've previously downloaded. So it's much simpler, much easier with SPS 01. So let's hit next. Having selected that service, we can create a Fiori Launchpad type app. If you want, you can be standalone, but very often you're going to want to embed into a Fiori Launchpad, in particular because Fiori Launchpad is now available with XS Advanced Web IDE for HANA SPS 01. Give it a title, let's maybe call it sales, a namespace, sales.ui. Then you'd need to specify what you want to go where. Now, this is not particularly new, let's just go quickly through. Choose an object collection from that OData service. So in this case, it's going to be region that we start with. So we'll start with region and then be able to drill down to countries. Let's choose the name of the region to be in the title, and then we've got the amount, so the sales amount for that region. And then for the line items, we're going to have countries. Again, we'll choose the name of the country to be in the title. Of course, you can come and change all of this later by editing the XML files. You probably know that. We've got the amount in there. So we've done the basic selections. We can hit next, and then hit finish. And this is where the magic happens. It's going to go out and build you all the configuration needed. It's going to write the code to build you that Fiori Master Detail application. So you'll see here there's quite a lot of code in there, and it's done all the work necessary to connect it to your OData service. So that's really new in SPS 01. If we go to the MTA YAML file, remember we have a nice editor now, so let's just maximize the space. Choose UI. This has been added. You can see, for example, that it's already requiring the Node.js API, which is a service that's created by the Node.js module. We didn't code any of that. It's actually been scripted and coded for us. So if we go and look at the code editor, you'll see that the UI module's been added, but the require section for the backend, the Node.js backend, has actually all been set up for us. And of course, that backend service, the provider, was already set up for us in the Node.js module in the previous video. So it's a lot easier to work with, a lot more straightforward. You don't have to have code that you copy and paste in. You can get going directly against a live OData service. So let's go ahead and run that. Now, you can run the component.js or the index.html. Let's just first do a run. So basically, the options you have, we can actually say run as a web application. That's going to use the index.html. So let's try that one first. So we can see that it's actually running. It's opened up the application for us. In some cases, if you've not authorized it, you may get a message asking you to authorize pop-ups in your web browser. I'm using Chrome. Actually, you can use Internet Explorer or Edge from Microsoft. That's also now supported with HANA 2.0 SPS 01 of Web ID for HANA. So we can see we've got our app, we've got the different continents, and then we've got the different countries in the detail section on the right. So we've built a Fiori app without having to write any explicit code. Now we can just go back from that. There's another way in SPS 01 that we can run this as well. We can actually run it effectively in a demo Fiori launchpad, because if we actually said that this app is something that we want to be available to run in a Fiori launchpad, and for that typically within web app you'd be looking at the component JS. So run the component JS, and for that we'll say run, but this time run as the SAP Fiori launchpad sandbox. So basically a sandbox, a demo Fiori launchpad that will then drop your application into. So that's now going to take a couple of seconds to actually go ahead and run. So now we can see we've got our application, our master detail, the same app running the same way, but it's within a Fiori launchpad. So as you can see, we can even go to the home. So we've actually got some sandbox tiles in there, and we've got the tile for our UI. So it allows you to test your Fiori master detail application, your UI app, actually in the context of Fiori Launchpad. Okay, now there's one other thing to show, that when you're working with index.html to run as a web application or in Fiori Launchpad, you've got another option. If you go to the run configurations, you'll see that one of the options is, and you need to scroll down in this case for it, is you can now run with mock data. So if you don't have any data already, you maybe want to provide it in JSON or have the system generate data for you automatically on the fly, you have that option. You can run with mock data. If you've used Web IDE that's available in SCP, the SAP Cloud Platform, then you might already be familiar with actually working with mock data. So it's basically the same capability has now been included with the Web IDE for HANA that works with XS Advanced and is part of the HANA itself. So that's the mock data. That's also new in SPS 01 of HANA. So what we've seen in this video is how we can create a master detail Fiori app. We've been able to run it as a classic web application. We can run it in a Fiori Launchpad sandbox. And we didn't really have to write any code. In fact, all of the plumbing, the connections between the different modules, because it's not just UI on its own, it's UI working with the Node.js service, etc. All of that plumbing, all of the code that was needed was generated for us on the fly. So we really had minimal effort as we built that. So we were actually building it against a live OData service. That's a major new capability that comes with SPS 01 of HANA 2 when we're working with Web IDE for HANA. You can find more HANA video tutorials on our YouTube channel. If you'd like to be informed as soon as new video tutorials are published, please subscribe to the channel. You can also connect with us on LinkedIn, follow us on Twitter, and we have pages on Facebook and Google+. Code snippets for all of our tutorials are published to GitHub. Thanks for watching.